Hi everyone, I'm Kevin at Buffer, and I'm excited today to share a cool tip about how to add to your buffer in bulk. So first off, I'll start by sharing my screen with you. And this cool tip is really amazing because it lets you add 50, 100 posts to your buffer queues within minutes, which is just an amazing time saver. So kind of the first step here is to grab an export of all of your posts. And there's a couple different ways you can do that. So we're looking at kind of the history of things that you've posted on Twitter or Facebook, LinkedIn, Pinterest, places like that. If you're a Buffer for Business subscriber, you can do this right through Buffer by clicking over to your Analytics tab and clicking down to Analysis. And this kind of shows you some of your different views here, and you can choose 30 days, 90 days, any custom time frame of data to export. I'll grab the last 30 days and go ahead and export that. If you don't have Buffer for Business, there's some cool ways you can do this just with the native analytics from Twitter and Facebook, places like that. I'm going to go up here to a new tab. This tab is analytics.twitter.com, and it's kind of a dashboard of what's happening with your Twitter account. This is the main homepage here. If you come up to the top and click on Tweets, this shows you the activity on your tweets from the last, they do 28-day periods. And again, you can customize the date range here if you'd like to. We'll go ahead and leave this as the last 28 days. You can click Export Data, and it will download a file for you. Once you've exported data either from Buffer or from analytics.twitter.com or from your Facebook Insights, then you can come over to something like a Google spreadsheet. Excel also works great. I'll show you here on my Google Drive with the spreadsheet, where you can go to New Sheet, and we're going to import the data that we just exported. So I'll come down here to Import. We want to upload the import, so I'll select a file from my computer. And here's one of the files, these two files here are the exports that we just did. I'll grab the buffer one first. And that's uploading, and it's going to show us, this here is just kind of where we want to import it. So we'll just add it as a replaced data at the selected cell. So it'll just be here on this first sheet that we opened. What we're going to see is a list of all of the posts that we have, and then each of the stats on the posts as we look through it. So here's the date that it was published. Here's the context and the content within that post. And then here's our stats for retweets, favorites, mentions, clicks, and the potential reach of our tweets. So what I like to do here is I'll freeze the top two rows. And then I can go in and I can sort these rows by clicks. So I can see the top post that received the most clicks. So a couple of them did quite well, quite a bit better than some of the rest. And then what I'll do is I'll look down and kind of grab a benchmark. So looking here, seems like anything maybe 29 and above kind of did better than the average post or better than some of the lower performing ones. So these are the ones I'll want to add again later on. So I'll come over here and select these. I'm going to copy them and add them to a new sheet. I'm going to export this sheet. In Google Sheets, it's called Download As. I'm going to download it as a CSV file. So that's downloading to my computer. And now we're coming to the bulk part. So thanks for bearing with me on these steps here. The bulk buffer part, this is a super, super wonderful tool. It's bulkbuffer.com. And this is the homepage here. You can go ahead and click on Start Uploading. It's going to ask for access to your buffer account. You can click Allow Access. And then this is the page here, so you can select which accounts you want to add to bulk. First off, I'm going to click here to upload that file we just exported, which is here. And it shows a list of all those different tweets that we had grabbed. And we'll go ahead and select the Kevin Lee account. And we come here and select Send to that account. So these are kind of working their way through here. I'll pop back over to my buffer and show you what it looks like once they have been uploaded. So this is the content tab for my buffer, and I've done this a couple times before, so I have a list of some updates. You'll see here they have via bulk buffer is mentioned within the content of the tweet. And yeah, this is kind of what they look like when they're in there. They're plain text at first, but you can come back in and you can adjust anything. You can change kind of the formatting so that it looks the way you want. You can add new information, vary your tweets a little bit. Our strategy from day one was about republishing the same content multiple times. This is a really cool tip on how to do that quickly and in bulk. You can add new photos and videos here, and click Save when you're done, and you're good to go. So that kind of covers the bulk buffer tip. Again, those resources were bulkbuffer.com. You can grab analytics from the Buffer for Business Exports or analytics.twitter.com or Facebook Insights, and put all that together and you have a cool little way of adding to your buffer in bulk. Thanks so much for listening. Excited to have you join us here. If you're looking for more tips, we have them over on the blog, which is blog.bufferapp.com. And we'll talk to you soon. Thanks.